Welcome back to the Too Familiar podcast. I am Marlena Ariel.
And I am Tushina. You can call me Miss Tish B or Tish.
Did y'all like that? Thank you. Thank you very much. You can find me on all platforms as well with her. We're out here on a tour. So if you ever need me, book me because I got that voice for you guys. I can do voiceovers just as well. You like that promotion?
No.
Oh,
no.
It's okay. She be supporting me behind closed doors. She be my backup dream girl.
I think you're my backup dream girl.
I be like killing it, and she be my backup thing or whatever.
It's so funny. Everybody be like,
and you Michelle.
actually, I'm Dina, and you're Effie. heavy.
heavy. You got so heavy on me.
She said, Curtis is supposed to love me. Curtis was supposed to.
No,
this is usually my favorite movie.
How y'all doing? How was your week?
My week was good.
What'd you do? What was so fun? You know, let me know.
Well, you know me. I just, you know.
Well, y'all know me. You know, like I know. Yeah.
No, my week has been good. Father's Day and just, you know, all that stuff. And I'm cooking dinner. Well, I cook dinner for my dad. And that's it. Yeah. At the house chilling. What?
I ain't got no daddy.
All right. All right.
I tried some new restaurants this week.
What'd you try?
It's called this one place. I got to think of it. It's a burger joint. Down in Texas. It's really good. It was really, really good. You know what other burger joint was good that I tried with her, y'all?
My place?
Yes.
Fire.
Fire. And it's crazy because some people be hating on it. It's called Hat Creek.
Yes. Yeah. And it's crazy. People in Texas really think that Sonic's is better.
Wow. Because what? Sonic's is okay.
Sonic's?
That's a disappointment.
No. And they love that shit down there. They get a burger and a motherfucking foot-long hot dog.
And tear it up and swear it was the best thing smoking.
Seriously.
Yeah. Sometimes I wonder about their taste buds because some of the stuff that they think is good, it really be all right. Like they sent us off with them tacos before one
they
time.
Did. And we drove like an hour to get them. The place was cute though. It was like a restaurant and a like convenience store at the same time. Mm-hmm. But
I don't say it every time. Milwaukee gotta stand up because Milwaukee got some good food. Like, yeah. Some people be trying to sleep and say, Milwaukee don't, but we got some good food here.
We need some more, like, we need a Waffle House for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely a Waffle House.
We need a Waffle House.
Right on Burleigh.
And it,
you know, the ones in the hood be good.
It depends on what at Burleigh, though. Like, it needs somewhere with some parking.
Yeah.
Like, definitely. Yeah.
Yeah, Waffle House be slapping, especially at night.
And what else we need? We need an In-N-Out.
I didn't too much care for In-N-Out. I didn't.
Over Whataburger?
I don't care for Whataburger either. Yeah, I like they was okay. Strips, but
yeah. In-N-Out is good. I feel like we can have one less. All we got is like Burger King, McDonald's. Yeah. We got like two Checkers.
Y'all need a Raising Cane here. And I understand.
Oh, they said they put in like, one.
I heard it be like, oh, because it's not seasoned. But that sauce, I don't care. Yeah. That sauce is what make it. That's
the bread too, though. Yeah. They said you first bought of all, it on Amazon.
You be slipping. You know how we used to be like extra bread, but we didn't eat the coleslaw?
Yeah.
You can replace the coleslaw with the bread.
I thought that's what we did.
No, we didn't until we found. Well, I just found out this year.
Oh, what the hell?
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like I've been saying
coleslaw.
I don't
need the, yeah. That ain't even yeah, coleslaw. Yeah. I don't know what that is.
And I need you to crisp it on both sides because sometimes they be just doing it on one side. Don't fucking.
And sure you put a lot of fries in there too because they be trying to be stingy sometimes.
We need to go to Raising Cane's.
Girl, yes.
Sounds I feel so like every time anywhere we go, anytime we fly in, we be like, let's go get something to eat. And then we go to Raising
Cane's. Cause come on now. That sauce. I gotta learn how to make that. They said that it's on TikTok.
Like yeah. The lady, I forgot her name, Kimmy Creations. Mm-hmm. She doing that. That's how I knew that you could get that bread off Amazon. Yeah.
I'm gonna have to look that up when I get back.
Okay. What'd you do for Father's Day? Cardi is in Milwaukee.
I laid across the couch. I watched me some Lifetime, and I went and ordered me some barbecue.
Not what is with you in this barbecue?
Barbecue is so good, y'all.
I don't know if I
want to be a barbecue.
I don't know if I ever had like real Texas barbecue. Like I had Dickies.
I haven't either, and that's so disappointing. That's why I'm saying Dallas got to stand up.
Yeah,
y'all a little too weak in the knees.
Cause
I have not had no good barbecue there yet at all, and I wish I remember these names. It was in Lancaster. They barbecue wasn't, and it's really the sauce. Like, come on with the.
It do like, be the sauces, yeah. And it's like sometimes y'all don't need to put it on there. Right. Like, yeah.
Let me get a choice. Maybe I want to throw this sweet baby Ray on there instead,
or I might not want no sauce.
Yeah.
Well, you probably.
I do, but it gotta be the right sauce because I'm definitely a sauce person. So
yeah.
I'm still looking. So if y'all got some recommendations, throw them out there. Let us know. It could be anywhere, really.
Yeah.
We should start what you said before in the previous episodes.
What?
How you going to travel around the world and try new stuff? I could be your partner because, you know, I'm down for some food.
Yeah. But then, okay, after I said that, I did think about it because I'm not really up to trying anything.
Why not?
Like, you know, there's people out there. It's people like... I don't know, like people like Deira on YouTube who would like she be eating squid and no.
I seen that in the store. They was actually selling the octopus tentacle thing.
Remember Mel? You see?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She would try some stuff. That's who you would have took.
See, I feel like I try stuff, but I don't trust.
It depends what it is. TikTok grinding a lot to you. I feel like if you see somebody good on TikTok, say. Oh yeah, this is good. She going to try it
for sure.
Look,
then I'm gonna go through. I'm gonna look at the sound. Look at how what everybody said about it. All type of shit. Yeah. That's why I can't wait to go. It's this place. And when a couple weeks ago when we was in Atlanta, it was this Biera taco place I want to try. We never got to go, I forgot what it's called. But it was plenty of TikToks about it, and they had a few locations, and I really want to try it.
Yeah.
So we should just go.
I'm
honestly,
glad she found Taco Mac. I'm gonna always talk about that. Taco Mac was. Them egg rolls.
Yeah.
I'm going to try that one day at home. Philly egg rolls. So good.
But, that probably is good. I done made some corned beef egg rolls.
Yeah. Fire.
Oh, I'm like, what just happened? But anyway, since it was Father's Day, it is Father's Day, I mean. We was kind of going to get into family a little bit and growing up with the fathers that we had. What you want to say? Why are you making that face?
Nothing.
Why are you looking like that?
I was just looking.
Oh, I feel like you was making it look like you was about to say something.
No.
I feel like sometimes a lot of people... You know, they say how they feel like I grew up a little better by having like a two-parent household type of, but I feel like personally, sometimes growing up, my dad was not, he was there physically, but like emotionally and like being supportive, no.
You don't think so?
No. And I hate that sometimes because I know now, like his situation that he's in now, he's kind of wanting to
build that relationship.
He wants to build it. And sometimes still inside of me is like, like back when I was a kid, I feel like I used to hate my dad when I was a kid.
Really?
Yeah. Only because it was like, even the relationship that he had with my mom, like they were very close, but at the same time, they were very sick.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like sometimes they had that constant irritation of just being irritated naturally because I'm sick and then we around each other. We're both sick. I'm worrying about you. We got these two kids. Like,
right.
So sometimes I used to feel like his support for her wasn't shown to me. But at the same time, I was a kid.
Right.
So it's like a lot of things I didn't get to see, obviously, because I'm a child.
Right.
But from what I did see, it didn't feel that way. And now growing up, I know people be like, oh, you know, you should have a conversation with them and just But I don't know if he would be receptive of it. I don't know.
I feel like Grandpa would. I just feel like, I don't know. I feel like that's not bad. But you know how people try to guilt trip you? Mm-hmm. Like, oh, well, I didn't even know you felt like that. But, you know, I was there. They're trying to make you feel like your feelings are kind of.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I feel like you should. You never know.
Yeah.
It might bring peace to both of y'all.
Maybe.
I ain't had no daddy. I'm lying. Look how she's looking at me. I had a pops growing up.
You keep saying that as if somebody has denied that you had a dad.
I grew up in a two-parent household as well. It was fun. But then my parents got divorced. So, yeah. And after they got divorced, I feel like me and my father's relationship got divorced too. Because mm-hmm. it was just like, okay, I don't hear from him. And I'm okay with reaching out to people. But it's like, sometimes I do fall back if I feel like I'm the one reaching out way too much. I just feel like our conversation changed. I felt like I was actually what do they call it? A girl's dad or something?
A daddy's girl.
A daddy's girl. I feel like even though he wasn't my biological father, I grew up with him in the house. So he was my biological father in my head. Well, y'all call me delusional, whatever. He was a great dad. He was a great person. He was my brother dad. I just felt like after the years, once they started to get divorced, that relationship kind of trickled away. I'm not sure why or what happened.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
So you talking about me rekindling something? Do you ever feel like you be wanting to?
No. And why I don't? Because it's awkward. Like, I feel like I don't know how to even explain it. It just sometimes feel like I'm the one trying to carry the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, okay, I don't want to continue to keep doing that. I still love me. I still call my dad.
Yeah.
And I ain't no bad blood over here for me. I don't know. I don't know.
I think, well, your dad being 20 years older than me, I never had a relationship with them. Mm-hmm. I never had a relationship with any of my siblings, actually, besides obviously Mel and then Tyler when we were kids. But then when Tyler went away, well, back to Madison, it was almost like never even spoke of again.
Right. That's crazy. I feel like I only remember her visiting once ever.
Yeah. Kind of me too, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like when we went on that trip, we went to the Dells. But other than that, I don't remember nothing about it either. And then we just kind of started, me and my sister, she's like a year or two older than me. And we just started back talking recently, and I'm going to go visit her. She has a baby. I'm going to go to Madison to visit her.
Yeah. Exciting.
Well, I think I told you, like, we had talked about it, but mm-hmm. I didn't know, like, when I was going to go. I think I'm going to go after the 75 heart
mm-hmm.
and probably, like, the end of August. But, yeah, I feel like I used to be like, oh, I really didn't care about it,
mm-hmm.
but then now being older, I feel like I'm starting to be like,
you want that relationship?
Like, I want it, but I don't know if I care enough to pursue it or keep it going.
Yeah, especially, well, I'm not speaking on your situation or nobody's situation. If it's like one sided, then it's like, okay, what am I doing if you don't want that relationship with me too? Yeah,
and then I don't even know if it's that they don't want it. Is, you know, people, mm-hmm. Because I feel like people do be like, oh, people be busy, people got their own lives, da, da, da. But it's like, okay, you all make time for everything else.
Exactly. And same with me too. Want it. You gotta put the time and effort in just as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I agree.
So I'll be like, So yeah, but I have been more happier that we've been talking too, because it just be feeling weird. Like, now that Mel's not here, it's like, even though me and her was kind of, I don't know. We had stopped seeing each other a lot. Like, she was going through what she was going through and stuff, and then because I also feel like I'm not really close to my family anymore, like, at all.
Yeah, I feel like that too.
Like, for me or for you?
No, like, overall, like, I don't feel like I'm really
close
to none of my family.
And I feel like we used to do stuff all the time together. Like, we used to go on vacations together. We used to all go to the Dells, all type of stuff. And
I kind of blame you too a little bit.
Why?
Because you're a miss. I don't want to do that. I don't want to go. how you gonna ever get close if you don't want to go and get out and do some stuff? Because they be doing some stuff. Miss Marlena be in her room not trying to go nowhere.
It depends on, because I feel like I'm not, I don't know, it'd be feeling like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, I feel like I'm close to, like, my aunt and her kids. But then everybody, I don't know, I feel like we kind of fell off. Like, I'm close to, like, Destiny. I don't know how to explain it.
I get what you're trying to say.
And I do, like, it, I do feel like sometimes it do.
I don't know if that's what you're trying to say, but it's like because your mom not around and y'all don't go to the activities with her, it just don't seem like it's that hand is reached out really.
So then, and then like for a while, I wasn't getting invited to stuff, which is fine because I do be canceling a lot. But then after a while, it was like, okay, dang, like I really don't have people.
Right.
I don't know.
I feel like that, but I feel it's because my mama family is kind of like all over the place. Not like when I say all over the place, like you got some over here in Mississippi, you got some in Pennsylvania. I don't feel like we ever kind of met that side of the family for me to have like a relationship with them or too much know about them. And then my dad's side of the family, like I said, when they got a divorce, it's kind of like, besides y'all, I mean, we fell out for a little while, but you know, we came back, you know.
Because you. Yeah,
nah, it wasn't because of me.
Are you saying when we were, when I was a child and you got, oh.
I'm talking about when they got a, mom and them got a divorce.
Right. When I was a child and you got
you
mad.
You was not about, a child. You what? Was a teenager.
And you got mad at me for something my mom did, right?
No, but you not telling me stuff. I thought we was better than that. We told each other everything.
Okay. But, okay. What did you, what are we
first
talking about?
First of all, should I tell the story?
Are we talking about the baby shower?
Yeah, but I'm talking more than just a baby shower.
Oh, okay, yeah, tell it.
That y'all knew about her and y'all didn't tell me.
That's blindsided. The crazy part. How did we know?
Cause y'all said, should I? No, I ain't gonna say
no,
that.
No, tell it.
I should tell it on
Yeah.
Marlena said they went to the house before and grandpa told them not to say nothing, which I understand that, but we was like this. I should have knew. Yeah, Marlene was just starting to be real secretive and moving funny. So I was like, dang.
That's so weird. First of all, that's crazy.
And Mel was the only one that reached out to me, though.
What did Mel say?
Nothing. We just was like, oh, yeah. Mel was like, I didn't really care about it. Da-da-da.
But how can you say I didn't care about it at the same time feel like?
Because she was just like, that ain't nothing. Like, basically, like, you know, that wasn't. Well, she didn't really too much know what was going on. She knew, but she, you know.
So how is only
when I talked to you, it was like, yeah, I knew that. I'm like, dang, you ain't tell me.
But then you just said I told you that my dad said not to say nothing. So if he also told Mel the same thing,
Marlena, I'm not even gonna say it.
No. What'd you all say?
You what she said? No.
No, say it. We talking about it.
We'll tell Marlena because not to say nothing. Marlena still say something. So you should have told me.
That is not true. Mind you, we're talking about something that happened when I was in middle school.
First of all, we was really close. I grew up with them like my sister. So that's something I just feel like she should have told me.
And then, and mind you, again, I was in middle school. And we, as middle schoolers, my mom and daddy is not telling us what's going on. They're in the situation, also not being told what's going on. So then we get took to her house, and we're sitting outside the house, and my dad's telling us, oh, mind y'all business. This we
but
don't know what's going on.
Used to tell me so much. So y'all could have been like, yeah, we went to this one lady house, and my dad told us not to say no. I don't understand it.
But then, so
like,
right.
Damn.
So then how
so
we
then
know
when
that
the stuff would have dropped, I was like, put two together, like, dang, he took y'all to the house.
Mind y'all. We're all kids at this time, and she acting like me and Mel some adults making decisions for her life and shit. And then she gets mad and decides that she don't want to talk to us no more or whatever. So
Marlena
then
used to tell me everything. So that one little point, that's why I was like confused on why she didn't tell me that.
And then also everything. While we on the subject of Tashina also is a very terrible communicator. She'll get upset about something. Even this situation that we're talking about.
No,
she'll get upset about
please
it.
Give me my flowers. I didn't.
I'm not giving
grew.
Her no flowers.
I didn't definitely.
She get
that.
Upset about it, and then yes, now she decide instead of saying something, she'll be like, "Oh, I don't want to talk to them."
Yeah, exactly.
No, but I don't that grew. Is childish.
So, make that clear. I don't
grew. I don't know who you grew with.
Talk.
You didn't.
agree with you. Because if I feel something, I come talk to you. Exactly. Yeah. No. She won't give me my flowers.
Tashina's a very terrible communicator. And I really hate that for her.
I give my own flowers. Girl.
Come turn these buttons off. Because, no.
Why is she hating me?
No.
But we grew past that. Yeah, I was a kid. That shit. I guess we can blame it on us being kids.
First, I don't feel like it never was even none of us our fault. I feel you blame the whole shit on us. Like, we had something to do with it.
You want to know why? Because I expected better from y'all.
You know what I expected from you?
What did you expect?
Say something if you felt something.
I did after.
No, after.
Right. After like a year or so.
Yeah.
I had to get my madness off. And I'm like, you know, I miss
and that's kids. Crazy to be mad for a whole year about some shit that had mad, nothing to do with us.
I just didn't talk to you, but I wasn't mad like, oh, I hate her or anything. It's just like, I can't believe she didn't tell me. She don't love me.
Did you talk to, did you ask your mom and dad these questions, or you just automatically were just mad at us because?
Ask what kind of questions?
What's going on?
No, I didn't get to talk to my daddy, really. My mama, kind of, she expressed it to us already, so I didn't really have to ask her nothing. She was kind of being open about what was going on. Mm-hmm. And then some stuff happened where the girl or some other woman had pulled up to our house and stuff had went down.
Mm-hmm.
So I kind of seen it already. Well, we didn't see all of it at first. We didn't know nothing about the situation until that day.
Right.
And yeah, that's when everything kind of came out.
So, if you already got the questions and your answers from...
I didn't. That's what I'm saying. I didn't get no questions or answers. I'm saying y'all knew about it before I even found out.
We didn't know about... You assumed we knew about something because y'all we went over there.
Y'all did.
What did we know?
Because y'all was like, yeah, we went to her house before.
And then that was when? After it all came out.
Y'all
and
tell me anytime. And then y'all would tell me if it, y'all went to Century.
And then we putting it all to...
Y'all
two.
Would tell me if y'all went to Century.
And then we're putting it...
That lady house.
We're putting it all to... After say the whole thing though, after everything came out, now we're putting two and two together. Now saying, oh, we've been here,
nah,
we came here,
nah,
yeah.
Nah, it
but Tashina, mine, Tashina as a child, she didn't know how to put two and two together like that, and she wanted to make it seem like it's
I'm
our
gonna
fault.
Let Marlena have it, okay? Because
is it right or wrong though?
You're wrong.
Right? Am I wrong?
Wrong.
After once everything came out. And all of us clicking for all of us.
I had my right to be mad.
She mad at a fucking seventh grader about some adult shit. It's all that was.
Because we was better than that. That's my sister. She's supposed to tell me. Y'all would tell me if y'all went to the corner store.
But now she mad. But she can't even talk and say that she mad. She want to ignore somebody.
I didn't ignore her.
I think I did. We called you a few times, and then you wasn't answering. So then I feel like we didn't talk no more until I guess when you decided
to. It was crazy. Our relationship went from me being close to both of y'all to me just being close to Mel. Then it was like I'm close to you. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
I feel like I didn't like you for a little while.
After why?
That, after that situation happened, because when we was calling y'all, because y'all had moved to Texas, and then we would like call you and you wasn't answering, so then obviously we gonna stop calling.
You said I so hate then, your stinky
no,
guts.
It was just like okay, she weird as hell. Like, gosh, she start being weird.
Not she weird
for real. Like, why would you be ignoring my
at
phone
that
calls?
Time, you know, growing up, I just felt like I was definitely one of them ones. If I ain't messing with you, I'm just cutting you off. I'm not saying anything. We ain't got nothing to talk about.
Yeah.
But now I just, I be feeling like communication is very important. Like, maybe it's like half and half. Because, sometimes I'll be like, how we had that conversation about, like, closure and stuff. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I be feeling like that conversation needs to be happening, but it don't sometimes. It just depends on what type of situation you in.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like during that time I should have said something like, y'all was dead wrong for not telling me.
Dead wrong is crazy.
Dead wrong.
The two people who you should have been telling was dead wrong. That's who you should have been talking to.
My mama didn't know. Found out when I found out.
She should have handled it all with you. Don't bring it to me. That shit ain't had nothing to do with me. Don't bring none of that to me.
I don't know how we even found that all that stuff out, like about the baby shower and stuff, but it really didn't matter. It's just
we didn't know either. We knew the morning that we went.
I just didn't like that everything was so secretive. Like,
she didn't like that everything was secretive, but mad at us as if we were.
Y'all, we gonna leave that alone.
Honestly though, Moving on from that, because
I just feel like, you know,
my daddy have you been waiting on this moment to say that you blamed me and Mel for that?
No, I just blamed that y'all didn't say nothing. Y'all didn't tell me. And then, look, she's like, you blamed us for this?
Because, okay, I'm not going, okay. Because I don't want to make it seem like your feelings are insignificant. But I just want to say the part that me and my sister played was very fucking insignificant, to almost non-existent to the whole situation.
And I get what you're saying. I definitely do. I agree. But at that time, I felt like our relationship was just up in the up. Like, we told each other everything. And y'all didn't tell me that one part. And then you didn't even tell me you did you go to the baby shower?
Yeah.
I feel like that's probably really what I was mad about. And like, you didn't tell me none of this. It's just like you
was already not talking to us by then.
Secretive.
You was already not even talking to us by then.
That's really why I stopped talking to y'all after I found that out.
Because I didn't even, first of all, we woke up being told we were going to a baby shower. You act like we planned a fucking baby shower. Mind you, we're in seventh grade. My sister's in eighth grade. So she was in fucking ninth grade probably.
I'm probably in eighth. I'm in middle grade. But this is the key, y'all. She not understanding as kids, which it is childish when you go think about it now. At that time, it's just like, you know, we tell each other everything. You didn't tell me that. You moving real funny. You moving real funny. But I forgive her.
Some things.
So now I just get on her nerves now. I write to her everything.
But now, and then for a while, I feel like we did. When you was talking to Mel Moore, I feel like I can admit I was going through this kind of like judgmental phase.
Of me?
Just in general.
Of anybody?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then once life started whooping my ass, I said, okay, let me shut my ass up. I don't know shit. I don't know shit. I don't have room to say shit about shit. Seriously. And then I feel like after that, then we started. I don't know, for some reason after that.
I don't even remember when we started talking. I feel like I know we had a little conversation about it. And then after that, it was just like, yeah. Okay, it's up. We was at concerts together doing all type of stuff.
Remember I got lost at that?
Marlena was flashing her titties at concerts.
You wanted to bring that up so bad.
Her and Monica. Ain't that what
Yeah. Monica. Did she even flash hers?
Yes, y'all did.
Oh, okay.
And he was up there. Yeah.
This was a long time ago. It was days. I don't do these things anymore. Oh,
you grew.
I have grown. Okay. I don't know what it was. I definitely went through this little phase of like, if I didn't agree with that shit, I was like, what the fuck? Like, y'all doing some weird shit.
She definitely was.
Yeah.
And she, I feel like you was harsh only because you talk with your body too a lot. Mm. Like, you make faces and you be like, and that what you just did too. Mm. And like, okay, give me some response. Tell me some. What is that?
That's
okay. What you like?
Yeah. I be like, that's me trying not to be me.
Like, I'm like, this be you. Be like, well, I don't want you to think that I'm judging you.
Because that'll be the first thing you always says, Marlena, don't judge me. But and I'll be like, just because my opinion different, I don't feel like that's judging. And you used to.
I used to be so judgmental, but now I feel like she definitely worked on it.
Worked on it.
Yes, I feel like now you're more open. Like, even if you have your opinion, you just be like, you know, I just feel like this. But I feel like then it wasn't no. I had my opinion. It was like, girl, you was just. Like, dang, you didn't feel bad.
I hadn't experienced nothing yet. Y'all know, I feel like I was real green for a long ass time. Like, I ain't used to want to do shit. I ain't used to sneak out. I ain't used to do nothing. And then. I don't know. When I got my first legs, exactly. So then that's I feel like then once I got my first legs, I don't know, a lot
changed. Huh?
Man, and I said, okay, this life right here, this is
what they was talking about.
This is what they was talking about.
Let me figure this out.
Yeah. And then when I was doing the same shit and I said, oh. I'm a motherfucking delusional queen too. Okay.
Not a delusional queen.
Not even delusional. I'm really optimistic, honestly.
Not changing her words.
Really
delusional.
Not us getting off topic.
Right. But back to family though. even with doing this podcast, people, I feel like hearing the feedback has been good, but like sometimes even going back to us going to the festival, it really took, I don't know, I feel like it needed to be pounded into my head. Like, stop. I used to feel like it's crazy. I got my entire family on social media.
Right.
And then like for nobody to share, nobody to like stuff, nobody to comment or even, you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like it took me maybe a few weeks. Like, we going into about to be month three in a minute. It took me probably like the first 2 or 3 weeks to finally be like, you know, like,
oh, well, they not gonna support
you. And not even maybe they don't support it, but it's just like, y'all don't have to do nothing. It's me thinking in the back of my head, like, well, this is my family. Y'all should want to.
Right.
But I don't think.
I agree. I felt the same way. But another thing that kind of stuck out to me, which I be having a lot of moments where I just be thinking to myself, and I was even thinking about me as a family member. It's like, sometimes, like I was explaining, I don't feel close to some of my family. So I don't want to be, some people's mindsets are crazy. So I don't want them to be like, oh, she want to mess with me or something like that, or share my stuff. And it's really not even that. It's just that I always be like, even if I want to share your stuff, some people be weird, like, why she sharing my stuff? I don't even talk to her, stuff like that. So I really don't be knowing people's intentions or thought process sometimes. And I really don't feel like I'm close to nobody but you and like my mama and my grandma and my immediate family. So it's just like, outside of that, even though I have family, it's just like, I don't feel so close to you to that kind of communicate or do that type of thing, which I would. I don't have a problem. I just don't. I don't know. Some people be being weird. And then you just read. It ain't even about what they sharing and want you to share. It's some stuff that they say. So it's just like, I don't want you to feel like I'm sharing it just because you said something like this or something. Like that.
I get that. I don't feel like, I mean, we got a few like business owners and like on my mom's side of the family, but not really. And especially not in like media. As far as I know, I don't know anybody
who's like. I feel like on my dad's side, like, Grandma Cynthia and them side, we got people that like do hair and all that stuff. That they are one cousin of them, they like realtors or real estate, stuff like that. I would share, like, I don't have a problem, but then I don't want them to feel weird. Like, I don't know, maybe I'm just overthinking it too hard.
But I also think that just because we're born into a family don't make you chose. Like, sometimes growing up, you realize that. We're related, but like I might not really fuck with y'all. And not saying my family, I don't want nobody in my family.
Yeah, like y'all seen that, right? Exactly.
No, I'm just saying, like, in general, like, sometimes people just don't mesh, and it's like, not even on the support thing, just in general. Like, sometimes that's why people be falling out, talk shit about each other, and fighting and all that, because everybody, unfortunately, ain't trolls. Y'all just born into the same family.
Crazy. The day I got married, I ain't gonna lie, I had started crying because I feel like most of my family wasn't there. And I'm be finna try to cry again. Yeah. I'm sorry, y'all. It ain't
no, you can cry.
But no, for real.
I start crying too.
I felt like all my family left as soon as it was like my first dance, all this. Like, I didn't have the support, nothing. And here his whole family was. Mm-hmm. And I see they family like tight-knit. They always supporting each other at any event, always sharing stuff on Facebook about each other. Like, what's the name? Like, they showed me the real definition of family, kind of. And that's where I was like, dang, I want my family to be like that. I have this dysfunctional family that, you know, everybody all over the place, all this. I wouldn't say drama because I don't really feel like we have too much drama, but it's just like, everybody just doing their own thing. Everybody's separated. We don't have events like we used to, where it's like everybody at our house. We doing barbecue parties. We don't have that no more. Everybody is all over the place.
Yeah.
So it was just like, dang, I want that as like my family moving forward.
Yeah. It did feel. Yeah. It felt like it was just
his family
and me.
And then even when everybody was giving speeches, they all talked about him, and I was just like, dang. Where my people's at?
That was.
It's that.
Stuff like that, and it'd be like the same how you just said for me, how I'll be quick to like not show it for something, not go to something. But then at the same time, I'll be getting frustrated like, dang, my family don't show up for me. Like, even when we were asking about to come on here, And then just the not responding and stuff like that, it's like I be in my heart feeling like people don't show up for me. Mm-hmm. But then I got to think like, okay, yeah. I don't be, you know, I don't reciprocate it either. So I can't expect nothing from nobody.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
That's what we all got to do better with, like, communication too, though, at yeah. the same time.
And I feel bad for my future kids as well.
Why?
Just because I just pray that I'm with a man who has, like, a family in that sense. Uh-huh. Just because, obviously, you know, my immediate family right. is gone. So I would just, I don't know, I would want my kid to have that and not to depend solely on their friends
right.
or their friends' family, even right. though, like, even, you know, Toy, her mama considers us like her kids. So I feel like I have that. Mm-hmm. But I don't know. I would want my kids to, like, have their siblings, even though I'm only birthing one kid. I want them to have, like, you can have my kid to play with Cardi. Cardi going to be too old. Cardi going to be babysitting my kid.
I might have one more.
I'm saying Cardi's going to be babysitting my kid.
No, he not.
Yes, he is.
Cardi didn't sign up for that.
I don't care what Cardi signed up for. I didn't sign up to watch him.
Yes, you did.
No, I did not.
When I say I was having a baby, we signed a contract.
No.
That said, because you're my so auntie.
Annoying.
You had to babysit. You ain't had no choice. If I dropped that baby off tomorrow, you ain't got no choice. You got to drop everything you're doing. You watching my child.
You were so annoying when you were pregnant.
Yeah, I didn't do nothing but sleep.
That's the literally calling me, Marlene, you at home yet? Oh no, I'm at her. Well, I'm gonna just wait outside until you, or I'm about to come take a nap. Or then when you had Cardi, why are y'all over here taking a nap?
Because we just want to be around other people. Sometimes I needed that adult time, and they wouldn't need adult time to go to sleep, but I just need to be around the
dude
adult.
Literally got them ready, put him to sleep, lay him down, and then went to sleep. Like, okay.
I got pictures of us, like, all the time, coming over just going to sleep.
I love that for y'all, though.
Thank you. I don't know if I'm going to do that for you, only because, Marlon, I feel like, y'all, she going to be mean as heck when she pregnant.
I don't think so.
I do. I feel like you're going to be cussing everybody out.
Well, then nobody's going to say nothing, because they're going to be like, oh, it's because you're pregnant.
You be like, oh, you just getting on my nerves. Like, you stupid. Like,
I feel that now. So I feel like that must be going to be my baby understanding, like, okay, this is an annoyance.
I'm blaming it on the baby already.
I'm just saying, if it's amplified once I get pregnant, that means you're really bothering me.
I'll send you a care package. Mm. I'll visit you once a month.
Once a month.
And then I'll come see you once you have the baby.
I'm not even going to tell nobody when I'm pregnant. Y'all going to find out with the baby shower invitations.
Marlena, I'm going to.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
I'm not even going to be here.
I do pop-up visits.
I'm going to be in South Carolina.
I'm going to be there, too.
I'm going to be there, too.
If you go to Greece, I'm going to be there, too.
Girl.
You go to South America, I'm going to be there, too.
I feel like once I move back to Dallas, I need to be living downtown. And like
you going to move to Dallas?
But I need to be downtown in a high-rise.
I'm so happy.
Maybe though, if Kaylin move, I'll move.
Kaylin's gonna move.
That's what she say, but
Kaylin's gonna move. I'm speaking it.
But I really think I'm gonna be in South Carolina. I ain't gonna lie.
She just broke my heart that fast.
We need to take a trip there soon, so I can.
Wait, I do. I definitely wanna go.
Because I just feel it. You already know what I feel. I ain't gonna say it on here yet, but.
If it's calling you, if it's pulling and grabbing you,
I think
you
it
need
is. You know
go.
What I'm saying?
You gotta go.
It's tugging at my heart. And I think I need
ooh,
to go.
That's real.
Also, before we get into I Know You Fucking Lying, I wanted to talk about I'm grateful that I never went through that phase with my mom of like that fighting and I hate you and that calling me on my name and all that stuff.
You lucky. I went through it. Mama used to kick me out. Y'all, should we go down memory lane? Mama probably gonna think I think she a bad mom. I appreciate everything she did for me growing up, but she has some anger issues. Mm-hmm. Like, seriously, she beat me up one time, choked me against the wall like my feet was off the ground because she couldn't find a hairbrush, and she said I was the last person to have the hairbrush.
Mm.
She came across the street, embarrassed me in front of my friends, y'all, yelling and hitting on me because I don't even remember. I'd be traumatized. And I feel like that's why I don't whip my kid now. And now I heard that.
That's why.
Yeah. My mama was heavy growing up with the B word, though. Like, she didn't like it. So she never called me the B word. That was her big thing. Like, I don't feel like you should call your daughter a B.
Yeah.
I'm really not comfortable saying that. But now she don't care. She definitely used that word loosely.
Yeah. And, like, growing up, going to, like, people's houses, and they mamas was one of them. Yeah. Like, but then also calling me it, like, you got this motherfucking company over here, and I tell you, like, people like that, they be like, Dad, can you come get me?
Right now, because I'm scared.
Yeah, because I wasn't used to that shit.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Mama wasn't like that growing up, but now I don't know what she's going through, but I feel like she definitely be cussing me out left and right and saying some foul stuff sometime as a mom. And we done got into it a couple times.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like it started really in high school, where she just, I don't know. Maybe we're going to have an episode on that one day and bring her on the show, because we need to hear her point of view, too.
Yeah. See, me and mom, I think we got the closest. Like, once I went to Job Corps, I feel like we got super close. And then even, like, after that, I don't know. Like, she became, like, my best friend. Like, one of them.
See, and I love that, because that's what I want. I feel like I still talk to mom and tell her stuff. You know, I'd be like, I don't want to tell you, because you're going to go tell somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And I still be like, all right, whatever. You know.
I know. I'd be missing that, too, because I'd just be like, dang, I don't got nobody to tell this to. Or it'd be like womanly things. I'd be like, oh, I got to figure this shit out on my own. You I can't just me? Ask my... We're going to get into it. I know you fucking lying.
You don't want me to get her no advice.
What advice you want
to
give me?
You want to learn how to put a tampon on?
I already know how to do that.
I can teach you.
First of all, I remember when Marquita taught us. So
now Marquita taught y'all.
She like, did.
This is how you do it.
And I was like, I don't know.
I'm not sticking anything up there.
And she said, what is you confused about? I'm like, I'm scared. I don't know.
And then why is this thing blocked inside like, of me? Like, I don't understand.
Yeah. So, okay, I got Marquita to... But I'll be like, I'll be asking her.
Marquita is actually a good person to go to about advice. She really is.
About everything.
I love her.
I asked her to be on here, and she was like, oh, I'm busy, so.
Did you catch that?
But yeah. I feel like, moral of the story, sometimes.
Family.
You're not going to be chose by your family, unfortunately. Your family may or may not support you, but you just got to keep pushing forward and keep doing what the fuck you're doing and let it be that. Create your own family. Do that.
We could be y'all family. You know,
we can't be y'all family. Y'all need to send in applications up first.
Yeah, we got to do some background checks and stuff. You know?
We're going to have some interviews. Like,
I like positivity. I ain't got time for the drama.
Yeah.
Say the drama for your mama. So we finna hop into the what? I know you fucking lying. I know you fucking lying. I know you fucking lying. Oh, I'm gonna do a jinx. Somebody put me in the studio, please. I need a ghostwriter. Please send me some lyrics so I can get in the studio. I'm finna do our jingle. I'm gonna be the one rapping.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm down for that.
When you gonna come with the jingle? When you gonna have it together?
What you mean?
When you gonna have the jingle together?
When I get me a ghostwriter.
Oh, somebody gotta write that?
Yeah, they gotta write. No, they gotta write my verse, and I'm gonna get in the studio and I'm gonna rap.
You gonna have a whole verse?
I don't think I should have a whole verse. No. I feel like you hating on me.
I feel like jingles don't have verses.
This is what I be talking about with A Family Affair, because she's not even supporting
me. I'm just saying, I think it's fine being short.
I might want a whole song.
Okay. Okay. And then we can put it out there.
I'm
going
for real. Send it to my way, y'all. For real.
Not send it to my way.
Look, send it to my way. I rap it. That's gonna be our jingle for the.
She's not gonna rap it.
She hating because I could be a rapper, y'all. I just can't write.
Anywho, let's get into. I know you fucking lying. Go ahead. You go first. You go first, girl.
Okay, my one is, how many search engines can you name?
I can name two.
I can name three.
I can name four.
I can name five.
I know you fucking lying. Dude's over here cheating. Dude's over here cheating, y'all. Go, name your five.
Google, XGs, U.com, Yahoo.com. What am I missing? Google, what is that? Firefox.
Okay. As y'all can see, but she
I don't want y'all to see my thing. I look cracking.
She was just cheating and looking it up, but that's okay.
I'm not.
That's okay.
I don't even have nothing on here.
Okay. Okay.
Arlena is a hater, y'all. She just mad because I knew 5 search engines.
How many rappers from California can you name? I can name 3.
I can name 4.
I can name 5.
I know you fucking lying.
G-Eazy, Ice Cube, okay, Snoop Dogg, Nipsey Hussle.
Let me see. You said from, so that means they was born.
Snoop Dogg.
Hold on, let me look where he was born.
Nipsey Hussle, Ice Cube, Eazy-E, and Dr. Dre.
All right.
Yeah.
Who else?
Yeah.
Who you first say?
Ice Cube.
Ice Cube ain't from California.
Where you from?
I'm just joking. Who else you say?
Nipsey.
Yeah, okay. No, you name somebody else besides Snoop Dogg. You all know they from California.
All right, exactly.
It was one person I didn't know who you just said, though. That's what I'm saying.
Dr. Dre, yeah. Nipsey Hussle, Snoop Dogg, Eazy-E, mm-hmm. Ice Cube.
I swear it's somebody else, but maybe I'm tripping.
Yeah, you is tripping. Okay. Go.
What are those things called? How many, how can I put it? You know how, I'm going to give you one just so you know what I'm trying to say. How many movie brands can you name? You know how it's like Paramount?
Oh, what I can name 3.
What are they
like,
called?
Production studios, yeah, or something. Production, yeah, studio. Whatever, yeah.
I can name 4.
I name 5.
I can name 6.
I know you fucking lying.
Because I am. Paramount. Warner Brothers. Disney. What's that other one? Pixar. Dang, why is it on my... hold on. What is this thing called? Swift Motions. Yeah, that's here in Milwaukee. TDR. You know, we ain't
no,
made
this,
no movie.
Yet, right, no. This TDR, is radio.
Yeah.
No.
What is that one show? Marlena, help me out.
1. Done.
Moon.
And you have more than... You lost.
You lost.
You could have said...
the one with the moon.
Lionsgate.
Lionsgate, yeah.
Tyler Perry Studios.
That's Lionsgate. No, that ain't Lionsgate. Or is it?
I don't fucking know. But yeah.
What's the one with the moon and then they got the little guy fishing off the side?
Oh,
You don't know.
I don't fucking know, yeah. Anyway,
well, that concludes.
Oh, you don't got another one?
No, I don't.
Y'all need to get on Tashina.
That
she
was
she
mine. I said with the and I said what is it? And I said what is it called? And then you said production studio.
Oh. Okay, my last one.
Yeah.
I thought you
get off my case.
One. My last one is how many YouTubers can you name?
I can name 4.
I name 5.
I can name 6.
I can name 7.
I know you're fucking lying.
7? Okay. Hold on.
What are you doing?
I'm setting the timer.
Okay. Go ahead, set the timer.
Kai Cenat.
I don't know who that is.
Duke Dennis.
Kai? Okay.
Duke Dennis.
Mm-hmm. Don't know who that is.
Neek. Jazz. Armand. Regine. Baja.
Is that the girl from OMG Girls? She got a YouTube?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that. You know what's crazy? When I was in Atlanta for college, my college tour, people used to say I looked like her.
Really?
Yeah.
I feel like she's not really like rememberable to me. I don't know what she like. Okay.
That's the only way I knew who you was talking about. Because mm-hmm. people's like, oh, you look like Baja. You used to, you know.
That's crazy.
And she's pretty to me. That's true.
Yeah.
Not saying that I'm insecure by myself, but
let me
yeah,
look her
I just
up.
Didn't think I looked like her. But I do get my hair ideas since they think I look like her. If I think she look good in it, then I just try.
You'd be like, oh, I might.
Maybe I could pull it off.
Oh.
Yeah. look at her when she was back in like high school.
I don't think so. She kind of looked like China McClain's sister. Yeah, she did. Lauren.
The oldest one, right? The one right here. She looked like the oldest one. The one that played in Daddy's Little Girl. With
them. All of them played in there. I'm right. The oldest one. No, not the oldest one, but the one in the middle. Mm. Yeah, this one. Where she at? This one. This one.
Nah, she giving me the oldest.
Yeah, still. This yeah, one. Yeah. See, she look like her to me.
No, she look like her. Mm. Well, she can be a McClane. She can pass for it.
But.
By the way, your daddy.
Her dad was like somebody famous already, wasn't he?
I don't know.
I don't fucking know either. Anyway, this has been another episode of the Too Familiar Podcast. Make sure you're following us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok. YouTube. Subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Find us on Spotify, Amazon, whatever. Yeah,
wherever you listen
there.
To
podcasts.
And we fuck with y'all for fucking with us, period. And we will be back.
Can be our family forever.
We'll be back next week. Bye. Bye. Nobody.